There is no greater diamond than that of faith. Faith in oneself, faith in God, and faith in others. A pleasant morning to you, my dear brothers and sisters. We have heard, faith in God can move the mountains, and trust in Him can calm the sea. This is the message that we get from the first reading of the day, taken from Hebrews chapter 11, verses 32 to 40. Here we read, "Brethren, what more shall I say? For time would fail me to tell of Gideon, Barak, Samson, Jephthah, of David and Samuel, and the prophets, who through faith conquered kingdoms, enforced justice, obtained promises, stopped the mouths of lions, quenched the power of fire, escaped the edge of the sword, and were made strong out of weaknesses, became mighty in war." When the shield of faith was upon all these prophets, they could win the battle of their life. They could win the power of the evil one with the grace of God. As we read in the book of 2 Maccabees, when Judah and his companions, they saw their enemies, they were coming to fight with them. They knelt down and prayed to God. "Dear God, they trust in their weapons and in their right of doing. But we trust in the Almighty God, who with a mere of nod can only not destroy the evil one, but also the whole world." Dear friends, if faith is there in us, we can conquer the world. The troubles and the problems of our life would turn to as nothing. But the condition is, have faith in God. God who is all powerful, almighty, and who is the source of our happiness, our life, and our grace. In today's gospel, dear friends, we have a beautiful message. Be aglow in the Spirit of the Lord. In the gospel of the day, taken from Mark chapter 5, verses 1 to 20, we read, "A man possessed with the evil spirit." Now a question rises in our mind, whether he wanted it or not. Whether he wanted it or not, he was possessed with the evil spirit. And that evil spirit led him to the tombs. He became a sign of destruction for the others. Dear friends, now the gospel invites us to aglow with the spirit. If the spirit of negativism, hatred, impurities, self-centeredness dwell in us, we would become the cause of destruction for others. At the end of the gospel, we find when Jesus healed that man of evil spirit, he asked Jesus, "Allow me to follow you." In the same way, when the grace of God is in our life would be penetrated. All our negativism would turn to as blessings of life for ourselves and for others. As the word of God rightly says, trust in the power of God. When we trust in the power of God, when we allow the Spirit to live in our life, to take complete control of our life, dear friends, then we would become changed persons. persons who can change the world. As we begin this newborn week, this newborn month, as we step in this new month of our life, let us ask God the gift of faith. God, increase my faith so that I may depend on you. My family may depend on you. My community may depend on you. And the whole society, the entire world may depend on you. And aglow me with your spirit. Let your spirit shine in me and make me a person of prayer and blessings for all. May the Almighty God bless us all. Thank you and have a nice day.